Let's say I want these walls in black in my view. Will definitely look better in Revit, but accept it from me. Also, let's say that we want to hide our furniture. Okay, let's say that I'm satisfied with this plan, but how we can transfer this standard and this view standard to other levels? That's when view templates comes in, and we can use view templates to standardize our view. To create a view template first in your view, for example, do some settings. For example, let's go and make our walls black. For example, let's go in projection surface and cut pattern, and let's make our walls black. And also let's go back to the floors and let's make our floors maybe cyan. Let's give it a pattern and let's put it on cyan, something like this. Click on OK and OK and OK and put your style on something like maybe hidden style. And let's go to VG again. And for the floors, we have to assign it to projection pattern instead of cut pattern, because it isn't in a cut situation. And now maybe it's much lighter. Now let's say we want to hide our furnitures too and just have a floor in this part, and now we have our elements. Now from this view, I want to create a view template. To do that, go to the view tab and in here click on view template option, and in here you have two options: apply template properties, you can assign a template, or you can create a template from your current view, or you can go to the manage view templates. Let's click on create template from current view and let's name it, for example, test one. And now in this window, you will adjust that which settings you want to contain and include in your view template. For example, sometimes I don't include view range in my view templates because I have some views with exact view templates and settings, but the view range are different. So in that situation, I would uncheck view range in view template. For example, uncheck this one and click on OK, and now you have your view template. Now we've learned how to create view template. Let's learn how we can assign them in each view that we want and how we can assign them in multiple views. Now I'm in another view, and in here you can assign a view template with two ways. You can go to the view tab and in here click on view template and you can apply template properties. Or in the properties palette, you can go to the view template and you can choose the template that you want to select. For example, test one, click on OK. And now you can achieve to the exact view that you had, and you can do it for 3D and other views too. And also, after creating your view templates, you can manage them too. For example, I have one view template in these two views. Let's go to the manage view template, and this view template is 3D test. Let's put it on in here and let's find 3D test. And in here, in detailed part, let's put it on fine. And in shadows, I want turn on the shadows. Let's go to the shadows and let's turn on both of them. And in lighting, you need to go to lighting in this part, and let's make shadows much softer. Click on OK and OK, and you can see both views will apply those shadows because they are referring to one view template. That's the beauty of view template, and you can manage your views much better.
Let's say we've created our view template and we have a sheet with some views in it, and it is a little bit time consuming to apply a view template to each of them. But there is a better option. You can apply a view template on all views on one sheet. And before diving into this option, make sure to subscribe the channel and like this video.
As I said, you don't need to waste your time, and you just need to go to your sheet and right click on it. And in here, click on apply view template to all views. And then you can choose your template. For example, let's choose 3D test. Click on OK. Now we can see it will happen to all of them. The other ones changed because the scale was included. To make sure that the skill doesn't work in there, you can go to the view template and manage view template. And let's go to 3D test and let's uncheck scale in here. And let's do this process again and see the result. Now you can see all of the views have changed according to the view template you've made.
Sometimes you are not satisfied with your view template, but just for a moment. For example, you've hide your furniture in view template, but just 1 second and 1 minute you want to see your furniture, and it is a little bit hard to go and to turn off view template and those kind of things. But there is a option in here, temporary view template. We can assign a temporary view template, or we can restore the main settings for temporary time.
And if you want to make sure that you're creating beautiful elevations and sections, make sure to watch this tutorial in here that I will give you some pro tips to make your elevations and views much better.